an extraordinary time. There's a crisis. We must accept it. But we've taken the best possible measure. And we must ensure that there is no panic, that food supply is available in plenty. Delivery of all essential goods, including food, pharmaceuticals, medical equipment through e-commerce has also been excluded. And so have cold storage and warehousing services been excluded. As far as the economy is concerned, the finance minister is working on a package and will take all necessary measures to ensure that as soon as this crisis is over, we are able to bounce back.
Hello and welcome to India Podcast. I am Ankur Goyal. Today being the first day of the 21-day lockout period saw immense cooperation among people. To reassure that people are able to keep themselves safe indoors, government took the bold step and is now working in every manner to make the deliveries of essentials available as well as emergency services alert. Assuring that saving human lives is more important for the government, I have with me today Niti Aayog CEO Mr. Amitabh Kant, who confirms there will be complete arrangement for supplies. Listen in.
Sir, thank you so much for spending time to speak to us speakers right now. We would like to first bring to the point that now the government has taken a major step. Our Honorable Prime Minister has come and kind of taken the most proactive step of calling for a lockdown. What should people understand in the state of panic when a pandemic has broken in India?
No, first of all, there should be no panic. This is the best possible thing we could have done to save ourselves from this very, very unknown third world war. The first two wars were fought with weapons. The third war is a disease about which very little is known. There's only ways of lockout, social distancing, quarantine, which can be effective. The way other countries have managed it demonstrates really clearly that isolation and lockout is probably the only way to save India, simply because we have 1.3 billion people. We are one third the size of America in terms of geography, but we are very, very densely populated, and there was no other option. And therefore, after a very considered choice in this battle, the Prime Minister has taken this decision. And it's also important to understand that essential services have been excluded from this lockout. So, if you look at it, exceptions, and amongst the exceptions are shops, including ration shops, PDS, dealing with foods, groceries, fruits and vegetables, dairy and milk booths, meat and fish, animal fodder. And district authorities have been encouraged to facilitate home delivery to minimize the movement of individuals outside their homes. And delivery of all essential goods, including food, pharmaceuticals, medical equipment through e-commerce has also been excluded, and so have cold storage and warehousing services been excluded. Now, it's absolutely clear that this is critical, that there should be no panic, because we are supplying goods, we are ensuring that goods are supplied, we are ensuring that items are made available at to people, and people should go about in a systematic manner without maintaining social distance and should be able to pick up their essential commodities. This is really the key.
Sir, with the policy front also, we are also worried about the economy at large. Of course, there's a major concern about businesses not being operative for a genuine
reason. I don't think economy is secondary to the survival of the people. And first and foremost, it's important to make people live. And that is what the government is concerned about. As far as the economy is concerned, the finance minister is working on a package and will take all necessary measures to ensure that as soon as this crisis is over, we are able to bounce back.
So how sure is the government right now with the social distancing and the kind of lockout practice?
Well, it's taken the firmest possible measures, and it has done everything possible.
With this, sir, the last question here is, people are also cooperating with the government. A lot of essential service providers have taken stand on the forefront, our doctors and bankers. What is that the government would be appreciating going ahead to do for them who have come to the savior?
I think it's important that every state, every district must ensure that items are made available to the citizens of India. That is really the key. And we should be able to ensure that every good is made available to them so that essential supplies are kept intact.
Even for the rural economy, so even for reaching out the rural areas with the deliveries of essentials, is the government going to take the required steps?
Yeah, government has taken all possible measures to ensure that essential food items are made available to the people of India.
And so the last message, since you said there is no need to panic, do we see this time go by easily? It's a complete lockout experience for everybody.
It's an extraordinary time. There's a crisis. We must accept it. But we've taken the best possible measure. And we must ensure that there is no panic, that food supply is available in plenty. There's a lot of stocks, goods are available, and we should go about it in a very systematic manner.
Thank you so much, Amitabh, for speaking to us and sending your message.
Keeping the economic concern as an important step along with keeping India healthy, the Finance Ministry is already preparing for a financial package to be announced soon. It is important for all of us to accept the situation and not panic to help contain the spread of COVID-19 as the government is positive and keen on the economic revival. Keep safe and indoors and keep listening.